Hi everyone, hope you are doing well. In this video, we are going to configure the logs in our Spring Boot application and send them to Azure. So the software or the tool which is by Azure to analyze the logs and see the logs is called as Application Insights. That is Azure Application Insights. So that's what we are going to do today. We'll integrate the library of Azure Application Insight in our Java application or the Java project so that whenever we do logger.info, logger.error or exceptions, those things could be sent to the Azure Application Insight so that people can watch and see and observe the changes in the application insights directly. So I already have a GitHub project of Spring Boot application, which I have already set up here. And you can just clone the repo and see the things. It's a very simple project. It has a bunch of controllers. And here in the Azure, what I have done is that I have created Azure App Service, where you just need to give the GitHub link of the Java-based application, and it will automatically run the CI/CD pipeline and deploy it to the production endpoint. So for example, here you can see, I can just load the endpoint and I can get the okay response. So this is the controller which I have already created in my project. Now, eventually what will happen is that once the logs are configured, you will be able to see the logs in the Azure Application Insight dashboard. That is called as the log section in the App Insight. So here in your app service, you will be able to see the Application Insight section. And in the Application Insight, you can actually go to the View Application Insight data and you will be redirected here. So under this, in the log section, you can search for the trace logs. So when you run the trace logs, it will show all the log information, the text-based information here in the App Insight. The metric information will be something which will be also sent. And what exactly is metric information, we'll talk about, but you can see that the metric information will also be shown. The exceptions occurring in your code will also be shown directly here. So you don't have to worry much and you can just see the exception occurring in your code. And you can put alerts that, hey, if the number of exceptions go beyond certain number, then you can raise an alert. So those are also configured, and events also. So event is something like the user click and all those things. So they can also be configured and you will be able to see the events as well in your application. So these are the things which you will be able to see. Now let me quickly move to the code to show you what are the changes one needs to do. So I already have a Java-based application set up on my machine, and there are only very few changes which you need to do. So I have already set up those changes. Let me open the GitHub so that you can see the changes. The first change you need to do is to add these two Maven dependencies in your project. The first one is Application Insights -core, and the latest version of this 3.5.1. Don't use the old one because I saw some bug in the older version, I think around a year ago, because of which it was not working. Take the latest one and it will work. The second is this Application Insights Spring Boot Starter. And here also you take the latest one. Nothing special here. Then what you need to do is, the second file is not much. It's just, I already had the Spring XML. So I'm just changing from debug to info because there were too many logs, but not important for this demo. Here in the, I created one extra class called as telemetry logger, which will have a bunch of static methods like logger.debug, logger.info, logger.warn. So these are the methods which the outside classes can call. For example, if they want to log the debug information, they could call the debug. If they want to call the info level of logging, they can call the info, warn, error. So these are the publicly available endpoints or the publicly available methods. Likewise, the log event for the logging the events and the log exception. How do you configure the thing? So for configuring, what you need to do is to, you just write this telemetry client, telemetry client is equal to new telemetry client. And the only thing you need to set up is that telemetry client dot get context dot set instrumentation key. So the instrumentation key is something which you can find directly in your project. So if you go to this, your app insight, in the overview section, you will be able to find the instrumentation key. You just copy it and put it in the environment variable. So from the environment variable, you can get that value. And this is the key which I'm using for my application here. So this, once you set this, then it's just a matter of calling the method. So for example, for tracking the traces. So let's say you want to log the info and those traces. For that, what you need to do is to just create a trace telemetry and then call the track trace method of the Application Insight library. Likewise, if you want to log an exception, then you can do is tell client.track exception, and you just need to create an exception object. For logging an event, you just create a event object and send the event name here. For logging the metric, you do this the same thing. And other things are mostly the low-level things, like I created a map. So there are multiple severity levels which you can configure in your Application Insight. So that is what I'm configuring here. So that what will happen is that once you go inside this track method, you can actually set the severity level. So you can actually set the severity level, and the severity levels are these many: verbose, information, warning, error, critical. So they will show up in the dashboard. So if you go to the Application Insight and you go to the log section of your Application Insight, you will be able to see the logs by various levels. So you come here and we can just run the traces here, and you will be able to see the logs of various levels here. So you see the severity level. So you can even add the filters. For example, you can add where severity level traces where severity level is equal to 1. So you could add those things so that you get to know that, hey, I just want to know the things with the severity level 1. So what exactly is a severity level 1? It's an information level. If I want to know only the errors, so what I'll do is I'll go here and I'll do the severity level of 3. So I'll just get the error related information. So I can put checks in my alerting system that, hey, if the error logs are more than X percentage, then raise an alert. So those things also you can configure here. You see these queries are similar to the SQL queries. They are called as the Custo query language. And you can actually check out how to, you know, query various Custo query stuff. It's very much auto suggestion based. So you see where, count, you can write as summarize, count. So it will give you the whole count, like how many severity levels are there. So the ones with the severity level 3 are these many. You can even do summarize count by severity level. So it will give you what is the count for various severity level. So those things you can configure here very easily. It's a very good tool, I would say. I have observed other tools, but this one I feel is quite advanced for querying the data. It's a time series based database, so it's very much optimized for the time series stuff. Now coming back to the code changes. So as I showed you here, the only change you need to do is to have a telemetry client and then just set the instrumentation key. Then just use the telemetry client to do the operations like track metric, track event, and you will get the data to the server. So that's one thing. The other is this health check. So that this is the place where I have made changes. So how to use it? So using it is very simple. What you need to do is just wherever you want to log any information, you just write this code, telemetry logger.info, error, warning, debug, exception. So that the code changes will be actually, you know, run, and these changes will reflect in the dashboard. So whenever you call this endpoint, these things will be sent to the server directly. Here, one extra thing I have done in my telemetry logger is that for local logging, I'm still using SLF4j. So the local logging is actually happening on here only. So I have not changed anything here. Just one change, I'll make it telemetry logger.class. So the local changes are still running here. Now, there is one important thing I also wanted to talk about is various types of logging which I have done here. The one is the trace level of logging, which is very simple, that whatever, you know, level of logging is there, which like the messages which are there, that's a trace level of logging. The second is the exception type of logging. So all the exceptions you can find here under the exceptions table. So those exceptions will show up here with lots of information like type and method, outer assembly, outer message. So the exceptions will be sent here. The traces, the, you know, logger.info will be sent here. The metric will be sent using this one. So this is important for many of the use cases where you just want to keep track of the count of the event occurred, not the total number of events. I mean, the count of the event occurred, not the exactly who called a particular method. So these can be configured using track event and track metric. they are almost similar, and they both send the data to the server. So here you can see the custom metric will emit one line of row whenever you run the metric. So one line is there whenever you are running anything here. You see a lot of metric is being set up here. Likewise, the custom events is whenever any event occurs. So those events show up here. That's again one line of row getting added. There are a bunch of things around the metric. Metric is generally more powerful. So for configuring the metric, there is this, you know, the library documentation is this. You can read out this. But the thing is, if you are using the .NET based, you know, the C# based metric feature, then what it will do is that it will aggregate everything in last 1 minute, and it will just send one row for the last 1 minute. So for example, if I call a particular piece of code 100 times, so there will be only one row which will be added in the .NET based application. But in the Java way, it is still not supported. Right now, it will still populate 100 rows. So the idea around metric is that the count is important here, so that you can get the total count of the event and you don't really care about who called a particular method. Rather than that, you are more concerned about the counts. So it just runs faster because the counts are there compared to, you know, the string-based matching. So that's one thing. It's most optimized for the aggregate stuffs. So for example, you can see if I'm running the custom metric query, you will get things like a total count. Let's scroll right. You see item count is for the events, and for the metric, you will get the things like the total count. So here you see value count, value sum. So these things generally help you to get the total summation and get the performance. So now what we'll do is that we'll come here and we'll run our application, and then I'll run things from local to show you how things look like. So I am running the application from local as of now. I'll go to my browser and run the localhost 8080. So this is my endpoint which I wish to run. I'll just run this and I'll run it bunch of time. So if we see the UTC time right now, so it's 8:34 a.m. So we should start seeing the logs with 8:34 a.m. So what we'll do is that we'll just run this and we'll do the order by timestamp, DSC. You see, it's similar to the SQL queries. Damn. So if we run this order by timestamp, DSC, need to observe the log. So right now the time is 8:34 a.m. And we'll add one more thing. We'll add things with respect to local only. So we'll add the client OS equal to Mac OS X, client OS equal to, and we'll copy Mac OS X so that Mac OS X, so that we get the logs from our machine itself and not from somewhere else. So I'll just run it. You see, we are getting the logs. 8:34 a.m. is the time right now, and we are getting the trace logs for, you know, for these changes. So wherever I'm doing logger.info, warn, error, for those I'm getting the trace logs. For exceptions, we'll go to the exception table. We'll just come here and type exceptions, and I'll make it last 30 minutes, and I'll run it. You see, 8:34, I'm getting the exceptions as well for calling the exception method. So I'm getting the exception as well here. Event, let's go and check the for the event as well. So as you saw, I was calling the method multiple times, right? So I'll just go back and I'll do custom events and call the, so you see the custom events are also coming up, and custom metrics as well. So custom metrics, and you will be able to see the counts. So you can even have like summarize sum of value sum. So it will give you the total number of health checks being done in a particular duration. So those things can also be configured. Yeah, I think I'm done with all the things which I wanted to demo you. This Application Insights by Azure is very helpful, and it is very much integrated with the things which are deployed on the Azure. The only thing you need to do is to just add the dependency in the pom.xml. That's it. You add the dependency in the pom.xml, and then you just have to use it by setting the instrumentation key. And then in the health, in the other controllers, you can just call the methods and it will work. There is one more thing I wanted to tell you, is that if you go to the application here, when you configure Application Insight in your application, which I have already shared in the previous video, what it gives you is that if you come to the configuration section here, so you will see the instrumentation key is already configured for your application. So let me just come to the home page and let me show it you from here. So if you go, come to the configuration section, so here the environment variable of the App Insight is already configured. So I'll only have to, you know, deploy the same thing. You see the Application Insight is the environment variable, which is already set here in my, you know, app service. So if I commit this code and run it, it will automatically work. So this get environment will be there by default. However, when you are running things on local, I had to set up these environment variable by coming to this section environment variable and setting the value. So I had to set it manually when I'm running on local, but on the app service, it will just run. So what I'll do, I'll commit this code. And once I commit this code, you will be able to observe the changes, and I'll put the link to this GitHub commit as well, so that you can observe. So yeah, that's it from my side for this video. I hope this video was helpful. Till the next time, bye.